Hi everyone and welcome back to another tutorial, and in this one I'm going to show you how to mix Midjourney and another bot called Insight Face Swap, which we will use to swap faces into anything, any image at all, swap faces in them, right? Let's get started. And we'll first have to invite that bot to our Discord server, so there is an invite link. This is the link and I'll add it to the description below. You just need to click on it and authorize the bot. Let's do that. So you'll get this pop-up. Just click on continue, authorize, and the bot will be here. Right? And now when you add the backslash, you should be able to see the insight face swap commands as well. We already had the Midjourney bot. So perfect. And we can start working with this now. Now, how Insight Face Swap works is that you have to first give it the faces that you would be using for swapping, right? So you could add your face, celebrities, whatever. Just note that I'm doing this for educational purposes and I don't have the copyrights of the images I'm about to use, but let's see. So the command is save ID. This is to create a new face that you will use to swap in other images, right? And let's give it a name. So I'm going to call it Ryan. And I'm putting in an image of Ryan Gosling. ID name Ryan created. Amazing. Let's do another one. So save ID. Emma. I'm using an image of Emma Stone. Obviously, don't own the copyrights. So I'm just using it for educational purposes. Make sure that you own the rights to the image that you're about to use. So now we've created two IDs. You can check what you've created by /list ID. And you can see I have two. I have Ryan, I have Emma. And whichever one of these two you want to use to swap, you can just set it. So it's called set ID and Ryan. So now whenever I try to swap a face in any image, the ID Ryan is going to be used. Now let's give it a try. Let's upscale the second one. And now that we have this image, we're going to try to swap this with the image of Ryan Gosling. Click on this more, go into apps and click on InSwapper. That's it. The command has been sent. It can take a little bit of time for a result to come back. So it's a waiting game from here on. And there we are. How awesome this looks, right? Let's compare it with the image that we had entered in the first place. This is the image we had given. This is the Ryan Gosling version of Iron Man. Now let's try something with Emma Stone. Let's scale this image. Perfect. Now we'll first have to set the ID to Emma Stone's image that we had used. So we go back into set ID and use Emma here. Perfect. Now that the current ID name is updated for this image, we can go ahead, click here, go into apps, InSwapper. There we go. This is Emma Stone as Wonder Woman. Again, I'll just add the image that we originally used for us to compare. And yeah, it's amazing how it's gotten the face to go at this angle, right? So that's awesome. By the way, I also just want to add that it's not necessarily to just use this plugin on Midjourney generated images, right? So I could just upload an image here. Let's say I uploaded this image of Superman. And I want to replace it with Ryan's face. Although this image was not generated in Midjourney, right? I just uploaded this to Discord. So again, go back to set ID. Once that is done for this image, I'll go into apps in Swapper. Sometimes you'll get this output that there are 25 commands in the queue, so you'll have to wait, and that's okay. And there we go. We have Superman as Ryan Gosling, and this image was definitely not generated in Midjourney, right? So you can pretty much use this in any image. You just have to upload it to Discord and use the app. Now, what if I want to swap multiple faces in an image, right? Let's see how that can be done. So let me just add this image here on Discord. So we have this image here, right? And we want to replace the person on the left with Ryan and the person on right with Emma, right? So this is how you do it. You will again set ID. And in the ID name, you will add Ryan, comma, Emma. Done. Go back into apps in Swapper. And there we are. The guy now pretty much looks like Ryan Gosling and the girl looks like Emma Stone. Of course, this becomes much more easier if the starting images sort of have the same features as the people you're trying to replace it with. So if you have your own image and you're trying to replace your expression and things, stuff like that, it would be very, very easy. But still, Insight Face Swap has done a pretty decent job here, right? Now let's look at a new image. Something like this, right? And we want to replace the center person with Emma, right? How do we do that? So you do set ID underscore comma Emma comma underscore. So these underscores are now used to represent blanks. The bot will actually go from left to right scanning images. So what you're telling the bot is that leave the first image, the second image, swap the face to Emma, and then leave the third image, right? Let's see if that works. And it did. We're back. And the person in the middle now looks like Emma. And now, in a final attempt, I'm going to use another image. And here, let me try to replace this person with Emma and this person with Ryan, right? So pretty much the same way, set ID, two blanks, Emma, Ryan. This should work. So the output is here. Of course, his style looks a little weird, but yeah, pretty much done a really good job. This does look like Emma and this looks like Ryan Gosling. And you can see for every output here, they say like 9 commands used. Before, I think it said 7 commands used. So you have 50 commands every day. It refreshes at midnight UTC time. So you can use these 50 commands. At the moment, they don't have a paid plan where you can increase this, where you can make responses from server faster like Midjourney. But I'm sure that's just following in a few days. You can also delete the IDs that you've already set, right? So one way is to do delete ID and then add the ID name. So Ryan got deleted. Another way to do is delete all, and it deletes all of the IDs. So if I now go into list ID, we have nothing saved at the moment. So you can again go to save ID and start saving IDs from here. Well, that's about it for this tutorial. Let me know what more you would like to see in terms of face swapping or anything else that you would want to see. Let me know in the comments below and I'll make sure I create a video for you guys. Do subscribe for more such tutorials, and I'll see you in the next one.